When we set out to design the lights, we wanted to achieve more than the bare minimum. We wanted a light cluster, a light array of all the lights on the aircraft, which don't just comply with the law, but they actually enhance the flying experience. They make it safer and more convenient. A key aspect of luxury and high performance design is that details should enhance the presentation of the design. They're not there to steal the thunder, they shouldn't fight with each other. The biggest challenge early on was to get to the bottom of the legal requirements. They talk about form and function, but in fact, we're very much led by legals with the light design. Some of the legals were written so long ago that we've had roneo-copied typewritten documents to refer to. These haven't been updated in the intervening decades. So we've had to bridge the gap between the sense of the law, the sense of the requirements, and what modern technology can actually deliver.
Fundamentally, our job and our goal for the digital cockpit and for the lighting system, especially in night flying, is to enhance the situational awareness of the pilot. This is, of course, your primary flight instruments, airspeed, altitude, etc. But we also are bringing in an infrared camera display into the background layer, which gives you enhanced situational awareness of your surroundings, independent of the ambient light around you.
The whole premise of HX50 is that it's a magic carpet ride that can take you from point to point, day or night, in the maximum level of safety that's possible. Over the last few months, we've painstakingly developed all of the elements that have gone into developing an absolutely class-leading night VFR flying kit for HX50. Tonight, for the very first time in a field that's very dark in the middle of central England, we've brought all of these elements together for the very first time. And I think you'll agree, it's absolutely outstanding.